brokenness every day, it does something to you. It changes you. And if you don't process that brokenness in the light of Christ throughout eternity and see the way that he sees, then you know things begin to show up like you see on the news.
Woke up this morning, saw a world full of trouble now. Thought, how we ever get so far down? How's it ever gonna turn around? So I turned my eyes to heaven. I thought, God, why don't you do something? Well, I just couldn't bear the thought of people living in poverty, children sold into slavery. The thought disgusted me, so I shook my fist at heaven. I said, God, why don't you do something? He said, I did. I created you. If not nothing, who? If not me and you, right now, well, it's time for us to do something.
Seen in the 10 years that the clinic has been open, over 15,000 patients, over 13,000 of those folks have had the gospel shared with them, and to this date, over 2,000 folks have come to know Jesus because of the Christian Mobile Dental Clinic.
I've never feared anything in all my 12 years of doing prison ministry. You know, we want to do what's right for these people because they have no one outside to come to see them and do things like that. So that's the best thing, is the fellowship is the main thing that they like, but I like sharing the gospel with them.
The Lord has opened doors and given us the path that he has marked out for us. And we have gone from that meager beginning to this fall, we will be in 42 schools. We are so excited about that. Last year we had over 1,200 volunteers, but we need more.
We need to continue the work in the city of Memphis at One by One, because right now we are running a waiting list. We have 15 or 20 moms who have asked for the support of a mentor. And right now we do not have enough hands to do the work. So we need more women to volunteer to serve with us as mentors.
I don't know about you, but I'm sick and tired. Life with no desire. I don't want a flame, I want a fire. I want to be the one who stands up and says, I'm gonna do something.
Don't overthink it. It's just the gospel, and that's like what we're called to do. Each of us has that calling to go share the gospel in our city. And in the world, wherever we're called.
Having a younger family, it's harder to go thousands of miles away, take off vacation, get on a plane and all that, but it's quite easier to get in your car and drive 5 miles or something like that. And so you don't have to be in Haiti or Honduras or Africa. Those are all great things, places to be, and we are there as a church, but you're in Memphis the majority of your time. Do something there.
Not us, then who? If not me and you, right now, when it's time for us to do something. If not now, then when will we see?
All you have to do is be able to love someone else that is here. These kids, a lot of them don't see that in their home lives. A lot of them don't have that help with their homework. So if you can help a third grader with their homework, then you can come and serve and you can share the love of Christ. You can share who Christ is with them and begin to build that relationship that will last for a long, long time.
And I know God called us here. Anywhere God calls or guides, he provides. And one of the examples of that is how God has partnered Bellevue Baptist Church with Miracle Redemption Church to help meet the needs of the people here in the Nutbush community, because we as a church, the folks we are ministering to, we are not self-sustaining of ourselves because of the folks poor, don't have nothing.
You think of the great commandment, to love the Lord your God with your heart, soul, mind, and strength, and then to love your neighbor as yourself. And so anyone who isn't me or isn't my family is our neighbor, regardless of race, financial status, education. We're called to love them. And the greatest love we can show them is through the gospel.
We are the salt of the earth, we're the city on a hill. We're never gonna change the world by standing still. And no, we won't stand still.
I don't believe that it just takes a police officer or the police department to make a difference in our city. I think that it does take a village to raise a child. And it starts with, you know, our church family. It starts with other community leaders and community entities.
And then if they don't know you, you're just like everybody else that came in and say you're going to do something. But yeah, right. Now, until they see you time and time and time, so that those walls break down and begin to let you in, and they, you know, and they begin to let Christ into their hearts to, you know, to change that because they see that you're different.
We think that the church is uniquely positioned to show Christ's love to the nations and to our city. And so it's very important for us that we see people stand up to show Christian hospitality, to show Christ's love in action, to really love every resident in Memphis, whether they came as a refugee or an immigrant, or you were born here, that loving them matters.
So stand together.
If not me and you, right now, well, it's time for us to do something.
Be obedient to serve the Lord. Sometimes it might be uncomfortable.
Don't you have 1 hour a week? Eternity can look differently because you obey the call of God on your life.
Choose faith over fear. Let's love Memphis like it matters.
Do something.